Hello everyone, welcome back to MAT 28. So before we start, I just want you to take a look at our syllabus. So this is our syllabus and we are right over here. So today we're doing a video for week number 8, and I said that there's no class. And in this week, we will be covering section 12.1, 2, 3, and 4. And by June 30, I already posted the test. We have a test number 4, and it's not covering this section. Okay, it's not covering this section. Okay, so I will try to finish at least 2 sections in one video. But if I cannot, then I'm gonna separate them. Okay, so let's get started. So in section 12.1, I want to talk about rational expression and how to simplify rational expression. But before we do that, which is before we jump to the example, we want to know what is the rational expression. Section 12.1 and 12.2. Rational expression. We will learn how to simplify, define, multiply rational expression. Okay. First of all, what is rational expression? Yeah, rational expression is an algebraic expression, but it's in fractional form. So it's algebraic expression in fractional form. You mean they have numerator and denominator. Okay, so it's in the form px. I don't think I'm going to use this notation because you never learned this. So it in this form, in the form of a fraction, it means they have a numerator and denominator. Okay, and on the numerator, we have an expression and denominator. It contain algebraic expression. Well, I can say that it contain polynomial. Okay. For example, what if I have something like this? I have x over x minus 3. This is an algebraic expression. You see, on the top we have a numerator, we have x, and the bottom we have x minus 3. They're all algebraic expression. Or I can have something like 2x squared plus 3 over x squared plus 4x minus 1. This is a rational expression. Okay, this is also rational. You see that all of them is in fractional form. Or we have something like this. Excuse me. Okay, this is also rational expression. If you look at the example, you see the kind of similar to the one of the problem we had in test number 3, right? Remember I asked you to divide polynomial. You see, this one we can split them up, but this is the one we cannot. Okay, if the numerator has more term than denominator, okay, has more term, then you can split up. Then you can split up. Okay. So you over here you can split up x cubed over 3, 6x squared over 3, 10x over 3. Okay, so they look like one of the problem we have in test number 3, but During that time, we call that division, polynomial division. Okay, this is nothing but rational expression. So all of them is a rational expression. Of course, we not allowed to have zero in the denominator, because if we have zero denominator, it's undefined. We cannot divide by zero, so there's no zero in the denominator. Okay, remember that. Alright, so that is the rational expression look like. On the second part, I'm going to show you how to simplify a rational expression. Simplify rational expression. Okay. And the general approach for simplifying rational expression, you have to factoring. You have to factor as much as you can. Remember that. Factor as much as you can. Then the second step is canceling similar factor I say canceling similar factor, I'm not saying canceling similar term, okay? Because the first step is factoring already. The second step must be the factor, because you factor mean everything in product form already. Rational expression. Okay. For example, let's jump to example. What if I have something like this? What if I have 4x minus 4 over x cubed minus x squared? Okay. And I want to simplify this. Remember, one of the method of factoring is to find GCF. Right. So if you look at the top, look at the top and the bottom, we can find GCF easily. So we got 4 in common. I take 4 out. We have x squared in common, I take x squared out, so you have inside is x minus 1. So you see that you already factor. So I already finished the first step, factor as much as you can. Now, I'm gonna do the second step, which is canceling. So you see the similar factor, you see this is the same, right? So I cancel that, and what I have left is 4 over x squared. So you see that I already simplified a complicated rational expression to a simpler one. Okay. I can have something like this. I can have x squared plus 8x plus 7. I want to simplify this rational expression. And make sure that you have equal sign every time, okay? So in this rational expression, we have numerator as trinomial. We have another trinomial under denominator, and everybody already know how to factor trinomial. So I'm going to factor trinomial using the smiley method, this try and error method. So we have x plus 1, x plus 7, right? Because factor of 7 is 1 and 7 only, okay? 1 and 7. And factor of negative 5 is negative 5 and 1, right? It'll be negative 5 and 1, so we're going to be x here, negative 5 and 1. Okay, so some of you is not good at factoring trinomials, so please go back to the previous session the lesson I deliver in class, I draw the smiley face, remember? But you know, if you're good, then you don't have to draw the smiley face. Alright, so you already factored them out. You cancel the similar term, so what you have left is x plus 7 over x minus 5. Okay. Alright. Or I can have something like this. X squared plus 4x plus 4 over x squared plus 2x. So on the top is also this trinomial is you can use the smiley method to factor, or you can do the special formula. If you can recognize, this is 4 is 2 squared, right? So I'm going to use special formula to factor this. So x squared right here, 4 is 2 squared. 4x is nothing but 2 times 2x, right? So look at 2ab. 2ab. So a squared plus 2ab plus b squared. B is 2. Okay? At the bottom, I factor by GCF, so this x in common, so I have x plus 2l. So this is the square of the sum, so become x plus a plus b squared over x plus 2. Okay. So you also see that over here this x plus square, x plus 2 square, and this x plus 2. So x plus 2 square is nothing but x plus 2 times x plus 2, right? So this I can write like this, right? So you see that they have similar terms, so I cancel them out. So what you have left is x plus 2 over x. And that's it. Okay, so that is the way you simplify a rational expression. Let me see, I can give you a couple more example. There's many of them, you know, there's many of them. Okay, how about this? So the example one, this example two, this example three, is example 4. So you have 4 minus x squared. I want to simplify this. 3x squared minus 5x minus 2. Okay. Alright, so how we do this? You see the on the numerator we have 4 minus x squared, right? Let me make this a little bit brighter. Okay, so we have we have a trinomial in the denominator. You mean that we can factor by smiley method. On the top, what you recognize, that's the difference of square, because 4 is 2 square, right? At the bottom, we can factor by trinomial. So this is 3 is x squared, so a factor of 3, which is 3 and 1, so it'll be 3x and x. So a factor of negative 2 is negative 2 and 1, or negative 1 and 2. Remember, this is negative 5 in the middle, so I'm going to put negative 2 and 1. Okay, because I put negative 2 and 1 here, so I draw the smiley method, I add them up, it gives you negative 5x. Okay, And on the top, we have a different of square. So a square minus b square is a plus b times a minus b. Okay. All right. So everything is in factor form. Now we want to see if we can cancel anything else. 2 plus x and the bottom is 3x plus 1, so those factors are totally different. However, the factor 2 minus x at the bottom is x minus 2. It kind of similar, right? It kind of similar, except for the position. So it's x supposed to be on the top, you see x supposed to be in the front and negative 2 supposed to be in the back. However, the position is switched. So in order to be canceled, it must be the same. Right now it's not the same. So we will need to do something so that it's the same. Okay? So remember this step. Remember this. In order to switch the position, okay, you have to factor minus 1 out. So if I factor negative 1 out, I can switch them to x minus 2. So remember that, okay? In order to switch the position, you can factor negative 1 out. Okay? So if you put the negative 1 in front of the parenthesis, then you can switch the position. Okay, so after you switch the position already, you see that kind of similar, right? It is 100% similar, so you cancel them out. So what you have left is negative 2 plus x. Make sure you have to put parentheses, okay? 3x plus 1 at the bottom. And that's it. Alright. So some problem you think that it is similar already, but it's not. The position is not 100% the same. So you have to factor negative 1 out. Okay, remember that. For example, this one. Let's do another one. For example, I have x minus y, and at the bottom is y minus x. You know, you think that it's the same, but it's not. Okay, so there's the top is x minus y, and the bottom is y minus I. Now you want the bottom to become x minus y. Then what you have to do is you factor the negative 1 out, and you switch the position. Okay, and now it's the same, you cancel. So on the top, what you have left is 1, the bottom is negative 1, so your answer is negative 1. Okay, so that's the way you factor. That's the way you simplify rational expression. You factor as much as you can, and you're canceling a similar factor. So this is general approach. Okay, general approach. Alright. So, why we need to simplify rational expression? The reason we want to simplify rational expression is because it's going to help you later solve a rational equation, which is you already learn, you will be learning in intermediate algebra. So that's why I say that this course is a foundation for intermediate algebra and college algebra. On the third part of the lecture, which is it is a section of 12.2. I want to show you how to multiply rational expression. Okay, learn how to multiply rational expression. Okay, so it is similar, it's kind of similar when you multiply two fractions. Remember when you multiply two fractions, right? You have, for example, you have two fractions A and B, A over B times C over D, right? You just multiply across, so you multiply A times C, then B times D. Okay, then after you multiply them, you cancel, you simplify the final answer so that you can get the simpler final answer. Okay, so that is when you multiply two fractions. I mean, for rational expression, you will do the same. Okay, you will do the same, but because you already learned how to simplify rational expression, so you can simplify each rational expression before you multiply across. Okay, or you can multiply across then simplify. It doesn't matter. Okay, for example, I have something like this. What if I have two basic rational expression like 25x over 2 times 1 over 5x squared y cubed. Okay, so because you see the first fraction, first rational expression, we cannot simplify anything. The second one, we cannot simplify anything. So in this example, I just go ahead and multiply across, so it become 25x times 1 is 25x. two times 5 is 10, x squared y cubed. And now, you see, after you multiply across, you can simplify. 25 and 10, so 5 going to 25 and 10, so it become 5 over 2. X and x squared, remember how to simplify exponential expression? We already learned how to do this. So this is x to the first and x to the second. So this 1 minus 2 is negative 1. So you flip them down, so become x at the bottom. Okay, and y cube, and that is your final answer. Okay, so you can simplify right away, or you can, if you can, or you can multiply across, then simplify. It doesn't matter. Some of the students really good, and they look at this 25, 5, they can simplify this and this, and x cube, x and x squared. So basically, if they're good, they can jump from here to here. Okay, but on the test, okay, it's trying to show me as work as possible, as much work as possible, because so that I know that you really understand it. Okay, so try to show like this. All right. Example two. What if I have something like this? What if I have x squared plus x over 3x times 6 over 5x plus 5. Okay. So again, we can multiply across, then factor. Or you can factor right away. So I think that I'm gonna factor right away because I can see in advance that if I factor, I can simplify immediately. Okay. Multiply across. So you're gonna multiply across like this. 6 times x squared plus x. So just multiply, don't distribute it, okay? Just multiply across. So you have 3x times 5x plus 5. Okay. And you see that 6 simplify by 3, so it give you 2, right? So you have 2 x squared plus x over x, phi x plus phi. And x squared plus I, you can factor again, you find GCF, right? GCF, because they share the x in common, so I take the x out. So you have x plus 1 left. Right, and at the bottom, they share phi in common. So I take the phi out, so phi x, x plus 1. So you see that x plus 1 similar cancel. X and x cancel. So what you have left is 2 over 5. Okay, that's what you have left. try to find where's the armor pen, but yeah, just leave it somewhere. Okay. Or some of the students do like this, they factor the x right over here and they cancel with the bottom here. Okay. Then they multiply across. Okay, so I mean there are several ways to do this. Or just multiply across. Then factor and cancel. But don't distribute it. Okay? You distribute it, then you have to factor again. So it waste of time. So don't distribute it. Okay? Never. Alright. Or I can have something like this. What if I have 3x plus 3 over 5x squared minus 5x, you multiply by 2x squared plus x minus 3 over 4x squared minus 9. Okay. So in this example, I'm going to factor right away instead of multiply across. You can do multiplication right away if you want to, but I'm going to factor right away because I find GCF right here. I got 3x plus 1, right? 3 in common. At the bottom over here, I have 5x in common, right? So I take 5x. We already learned how to find GCF last time, so x minus 1, right? Time. This is trinomial. So I can do smiley method, so it will be 2x here and x here, right? Factor of negative 3 could be 3 and 1, right? 3 and 1. But in our over here, we want addition, so we draw the smiley method, so we will have negative 3 here, no, positive 3 here and negative 1 here. Okay. And the bottom, if you can recognize this is a different of square. I mean, when you do a lot of problem, you can recognize it. If you don't do a lot of problem, you see, if you look at this, you cannot recognize it. I mean, you can, if you cannot recognize different of square, you cannot use the formula different of square, right? So 4x is nothing but 2x square minus 3 square, right? Okay. And right now, no rush, I'm going to just go ahead and write out everything. I'm not rushing. Even though that I see the x minus 1 and x minus 1 over here, I can cancel, but I'm not rushing, okay? I'm just wait. So this is different of square, this is a square minus b square. So it'll be a plus b times a minus b. Okay. And now the next step, I'm going to multiply across. It means that I'm going to put everything under one fractional bar. I just put everything together, okay? Don't distribute it. Alright, so after I put everything together, I see anything in common? This, right? I cancel that. This cancel. So what you have left is 3. X plus 1 over 5x 2x minus 3 is the final answer. So this is the simplest one. I mean, when you get used to it, I mean, you can cancel right over here. I mean, you cancel right here, you cancel right over here, and you can jump to here. You can skip the, if you're good, you can skip this step. Okay, but I recommend not because you're kind of new, to this concept, so try to put everything together before canceling. Okay. So that is the way you're gonna multiply rational expression together. So when you multiply rational expression together, you see that you will have to simplify it. Okay, you have to simplify, you have to factor, then simplify. So you see that all the math concept kind of related to each other, right? In the previous session, you learned how to factor. Then the first part of the lecture today, we learn how to simplify. Then the third part, when you multiply, it means that you factor and simplify. Okay? And on the fourth part today, we're gonna do dividing rational expression. And the concept of dividing is nothing but dividing fraction. You remember when you divide fraction, you keep chain flip, right? You do keep chain flip. So the same thing over here. You gotta do keep, you change the multiplication, and you gotta keep, you flip it to multiplication. Keep chain flip, you change to multiplication, and you flip the second fraction. So you see that in dividing rational expression, we have multiplying rational expression, right? Because we change to multiplying, then we flip. For example, keep chain flip, remember that. So keep chain flip. Of course, but before doing that, we have to chain flip. Or we factor, keep chain flip, then simplify. It is the same, okay? So what if we have like this? Divided by. This is what I'm going to show you. I mean, it's not always a good approach, but I'm going to stick to one approach, which is I'm going to keep chain flip right away. Okay, keep chain flip right away. So I'm going to keep it, change it to multiplication, and flip it. Then multiply across, because this is like multiplying rational expression. You multiply across. Then simplify and cancel. So what you have left is 3y squared over 160. Okay. Some student again. Some is after you after they apply keep chain flip, then they can cancel the x cube and they can jump to this. But I already show you that you should write this step, the step that you write in one fraction. Okay. I'm sorry. This is example one. Example two. I'm sorry. My allergy is still been with me. Okay. How about this? We have 2x squared minus 11x plus 5. Over 5x minus 25 divided by 4x minus 2 over 10, right? All right, so there's two way problem. You can factor first, then keep chain flip, or you can keep chain flip then factor. I'm gonna do keep chain flip then factor. Keep chain flip then factor. So this is trinomial, so I factor trinomial. The bottom I can do GCF. Ok Okay, so factor over here 2 is 5, right? So 2 will be factor of 2 is 2 and 1. Factor of 5 is negative 5 and negative 1, right? It could be 5, positive 5 and positive 1, but it could be negative 5 and negative 1, so be negative 5 and negative 1, because you see that when you draw the smiley method, you get the negative 11. At the top you can, but at the bottom you can find GCF. You have 2 in common, so you take 2 out. So you have 2x minus 1, right? let me see, is this work or not? Probably a factor over here wrong, because I draw the smiley method, it doesn't give you, so this should be negative 5 here and 1 here. Yes, I'm sorry. Okay. Alright, then I put everything together, so I just multiply across. Times 10 over, I just put 10 on the front. Times 10, 2x minus 1, and x minus 5 at the bottom. I just rewrite it. 10 cancel out, this cancel out, this cancel out. So whatever cancel out, what you have left is 1. Okay. Okay, remember I want to see this step. Okay, remember I want to see this. Some of them is good, so they see right away, they cancel well, and you can get the answer. But it's good if you show me this step. Alright. Alright, let's see, can give you something else. How about this? Example 3. What if I have x squared minus y squared over 3x squared plus 3xy? You divide it by three x squared minus 2xy minus y squared over 3x squared plus 6x. Okay, so I'm gonna apply keep chain flip right away. Keep chain flip. Okay. Then you're gonna factor. So you see that this is a different square, right? A square minus B square, so will be A plus B, A minus B. Alright. Then you find GCF right here. So you have 3x in common. So you're gonna take 3x out, so you have x left. Because it's x squared, so you take x out, you have x left. You take 3x, so you have y left, multiply by the same thing. I find GCF. GCF is priority, so 3x out, so you have x plus 2. Okay, this is trinomial, so I'm gonna do a smiley method. So you have 3x here and x here, because factor of 3 is just 3 and 1. Factor of y, negative y, should be negative, will be positive y and negative y, right? So positive y and negative y here, or negative y here, positive y here. So let's do a mental math really quick. So I'm gonna do negative y here and positive y here. Why? Because you see that when you do smiley method, so you have yx, right? And you do another here, give negative yx. You see, you add them up, give you negative 2xy. Negative 2yx. Same as this. Okay? So this is a good factor. Alright? So after you factor it out, so you just go ahead, multiply across. Just multiply across. Okay? No rush. No rush. X plus Y And over here, 3x plus y, x minus 1. And now you can see something similar. You cancel x minus y, x minus y, x plus y, x plus y, 3x, 3x gone. So what you have left is x plus 2 over 3x plus y. Alright. And that's it. Okay, we cannot do anything else over here. Alright. So remember, that's this general approach when you dividing rational expression. Keep chain flip, factor, put everything, multiply across, then cancel it. Okay, they're all related to each other. Okay. All right. So I think that's all for the lecture today. I give you guys a lot of example already. However, believe me, it's still not enough. You have to practice for yourself. Do a lot of problem. You must be able to recognize a difference of square, trinomial, GCF. Okay, because so the previous session is very important. Okay, the session we have test number four. It's very important. You must grasp that material before doing this. All right. Alright, so in the next video, we're gonna be talking about adding and subtracting rational expression. So in this video, I'm gonna stop right here, and I'll see you next time. Bye bye.